I had a special request. So, I'm going to ask those like Jason and Christine, you need to come, and Magali. They want us to do one more time of the days, right, of Elijah. So, that's the one we sing like in multiple languages. And then we sing with other tongues.
That's a good song you recorded.
Yeah, well, you look, everybody's sitting there
smiling.
I mean, I fixed it.
So.
It was broken. You had to stick a pin in there. I bet you forgot.
Oh, yeah.
Mama.
Let's see on your borders of my soul.
Bibles and turn. I'm kidding. I do want to say something before we're dismissed. First, thank you all for coming. You have been just the right time, the right word, the worship. Y'all, in so many ways, have, more than you know, you have impacted us. And when I say that, that's inclusive. All of us have been impacted. Your testimonies have been incredible. To those that felt like you didn't have a testimony because you never did drugs or got drunk, or let me just tell you, you are a breath of fresh air to us. That not everybody gives themselves over to the world is an incredible testimony, and we want to thank you. And to those of you that were transparent enough to share your testimony, things you've been through, obviously I hope you know you really touched our hearts. And probably more than one here tonight would share in your testimony with what you have been through. And today I have no, I mean, I really believe that. People have been through, about the time you think you've heard the worst story, you meet somebody else who has been through a lot. Now for us here at Living Hope, I have been concerned. You know, somebody said, why aren't you smiling? Matter of fact, my own daughter said that to me. You need to smile. She was being kind. She understands that sometimes you just got to smile your way through the trials. But I'm going to tell you what's concerning me. It's, and I say this to us, I remember, and we're not that old of a church, but I remember when Saturday night, you would be in church. And you wanted us to have Sunday morning. But when I say this, but I find more and more people have things to do on Sunday night. Someplace else to go. Somebody else to see. Something else is going on. And I know that it's not just you. There's folks that aren't here tonight that ought to hear what I'm saying. But those things are just signs. Those are just evidence that the enemy is attacking our faith. And what strengthens our faith certainly is the Word of God, but it's also prayer. Prayer. And we've got to pray. And so I'm called 30 Nights of Prayer. I'm kidding. I don't want us to just like pass out. But I am going to say, and starting in the month of September, we are going to have one Saturday night, and to me, that's not like enough, but it's a start. We're going to have one Saturday night a month. Yes, Spanish service is going to continue as is. And I want to take away from that. And Brother Tillery is getting ready